So you still have though. Chlamydia? You still have chlamydia?
The person whom you're trying to reach is currently unavailable. Please leave a message after the beep.
See, that's when that is your child. That's what's inside of you. Oh, I hate this whole three, 4 months. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It doesn't have a heartbeat. It doesn't this. It doesn't that. Like,
yeah, if you don't want a child, just put it up for adoption. There's a family out there that can't.
No, but okay,
if somebody else is telling me, cool, like I'm not financially stable, mentally stable, I just do not want to be a parent right now. Think about that child. If the parent really doesn't want this pity. Chances are they're going to be the worst parent ever, and then that's when you think about the child.
I feel like it's not considered a life when the baby has reached 6 months in the womb.
What?
Oh, in the womb.
You know the baby's moving and everything before that, but it has life at 6 months.
Yeah, it's now like able to breathe independently and stuff like that.
Well, I'm not involved in that, but.
So that's no, but then that means that you fluctuate what you consider somebody to have life or not. Because if you think that, oh, at 6 months, because it's liable, you can do things. But so what about like people who are disabled or who have to live off of like life tubes or somebody that's on life support and stuff like that? Like, so what, we can do whatever we want with them? They're not considered.
I'm not saying that you should wait till 6 months along the pregnancy to have an abortion. But I feel like you have that period of time there to make up your mind. It sounds like weird, but. Those who get what I'm saying,
Let me ask you a question, yeah? All of you lot. What do you like doing? In general, as a hobby, all you lot stuff, what do you lot like to do?
YouTube.
Skating. What do you like to do?
Smoke.
Listen, I watch anime, innit?
I watch anime as well.
Listen, I feel like every human there, every life deserves to have something to enjoy. Okay. You're not giving them a chance to enjoy. You know,
I would never bring a child
into this world to be a witness person if I know I don't have the capability to do it. Like, I don't agree with that. Because I'm not saying that I would ever encourage my girlfriend to have an abortion, because I feel like I love kids and all of that. But I'm just basically saying, if I was ever to be put in that situation where it's a thing where I am not able to, I don't have the financial resources, even mentally, that I'm not correct and stuff like that, I don't feel like I would put that child through that, because I don't feel like I should offload. A child is my responsibility. Why am I then gonna impregnate somebody and then give that to somebody else because the option is there? Because the option never used to be there, like a long time ago.
I understand that, but this is nothing new to you. You knew this before. So I feel like people are so careless, and that's why it triggers me so much, because people our age are so careless. They don't care. They just do what they want, and then all of a sudden their life hits them once they find out. That they're pregnant or something like that.
But in cases like that, abortion shouldn't even be allowed. But there's some cases where people legit, like if they have a pickney, it's not good for the parent or the child. Like, you're setting them both up to struggle. Why would you want to have a child knowing you are going to struggle?
If anybody here, I don't think anybody here is like worse off or like is living a terrible life. Right. Like, because we all look put together. Okay. I know that can be like a cover or whatever. Mm-hmm. But I personally feel like if anybody here was to either get pregnant, God forbid, or find out someone else is pregnant, God forbid, I don't feel like, oh, you would struggle or like to the max that people are actually thinking. I don't think that would actually happen. Oh, I mean, it might not be the most amazing life. It might slow you down and stuff like that.
If I put this in a more personal thing, because you lot know from my YouTube channel and stuff like that. So I feel like if I was to be that careless and if somebody was to get pregnant, in my situation, I'd be stressing about it. But then, because I know my capabilities and I know I'll find some sort of means to be able to provide, because I always do that for myself, I feel like that child, I would welcome that child, because I know I'll make ends meet somehow in that sense. But some people do not have that capability to do that, because some people don't know, some people are not natural hustlers and stuff like that. Some people don't know how to find opportunities and make money and stuff like that. Some people don't know how to care for others. She said, do you think I should tell my current boyfriend about the chlamydia that I had caught from my ex, or should I sort it out and not tell him?
Oh, so you still have chlamydia? You still have chlamydia.
He died.
That is disgusting.
Anybody ever give me some type of STD, I'm throwing you down the stairs head first, bro. No, you can't do that. You can't do that.
You need listen, to tell him.
And why are you walking around chlamydia for that long?
I'm not supporting it, bro. It could be far worse.
That's just nasty, be honest man. And like.
I mean, just tell him. If you respect it more if you tell him.
I watched somebody's video. They said that like if they got the chlamydia and they gave it to them and they'll go like clean up themselves first and then come back and then let them be like let him think that he got it from somebody else or something like that. I feel like before we even go into the relationship, we're going like we're taking a trip down to the clinic and I have to see that we both have to exchange test results the moment we step out of the room. See the text message, because I think they do it by text message as well.
Yeah.
You give the doctor my text message and I give the doctor yours.
They send you the text back.
Text number, sorry, or not.
And I think she should just be honest and tell him. And just explain the situation. No, but Mandy will gonna not
receive that properly though, because I know for a fact.
But why? That's what I'm saying. You're so immature. What's the problem? If she got it from her ex, let's say she got it from her ex, and then obviously she's done her checkup and blah blah blah. She's gone. She's found it. She's like, right, like, what the hell? Obviously, she's.
Well, chlamydia must have. I know not in all cases on chlamydia, but you must notice your discharge changes and stuff like that. So the fact that you are experiencing this and you still didn't think, oh, let me.
Do you know, you don't know nothing about the girl's body, do you?
No, but like, okay. I know certain parts of like...
No, but that's what I'm saying, no, understand. No, but some things like, they don't even have symptoms or nothing. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, some things like don't. And sometimes if like something changes in like a girl's body, it could be simply just because of their flipping diet, bro. Like, they could, just their diet alone could change anything. Like wearing like proper tight clothes or just bare stuff like could change it. It's not just like sleeping with people. Yeah, like so much things. If you're a girl, I don't care who this upsets. If you're a girl and you're doing bath bombs,
just make sure you're clean, innit?
That's what I'm saying. Like stuff like that, like can change your pH and stuff like that. So sometimes it could be like, right, could have been because that.
Same months,
but mandem as well.
No, mandem. Just make sure if you have foreskin, you don't have foreskin. Just clean yourself. Simple.
And that as well. Mandem on tight boxes, you know that affects your fertility. You know.
Alright, guys. Next dilemma. My boy best friend and my boyfriend hate each other. What the f*** do I do?
One of them needs to get dropped. Either both of them or none.
What's the problem?
It's who you're looking to that lines of innit.
Oh wait. I have to ask this question. Do you lots? Well, girls.
Do you think it's okay for your man to have a girl best friend?
Yeah.
No.
Mm-mm. No.
Actually, it depends, you know, like, it depends. Okay. Well, it does. Because if, it does. Because let's say you and a person that like, literally grew up together, like, there's people that have
different. No, but then a sis, that's like, you can't even.
No, but then if, let's say you call that person your best friend, let's say that's the one of the only people that you grew up with from young, you've known them, da 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 da. Like, me, that's not an issue. Like, do you know what I mean? And I feel like if.
Do you feel like you'd be able to coexist in the same like environment and stuff like that? Like if you lots were together, you lots would be able to like joke around. Da, da, da,
even if it was like a recent friend,
yeah.
And they became close after. Like I personally feel like, you and that person could still be like really close with this type of stuff.
Yeah.
But that person would have to respect that person's in a relationship.
Okay.
So things would tone down all this type of stuff. So
they're gonna spend
like you could still like things would like change.
Your girl should be able to go to her friends. I say to her friends, rah, like he annoys me. Do you think I'm right? Do you think I'm wrong? Like, give me advice. What do you think?
Yeah.
And your boy should be able to go to his boys and say, look, my girl annoyed me. Blah 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 blah. It shouldn't be your boy can go to Sharkeesha and say, tell me about like what do you.
But is Sharkeesha who's Sharkeesha? Like, is she
a new best friend?
Yeah, that's when I don't get that.
I feel like
if she's an old friend, then I'm gonna look at her like part of your family.
Not gonna lie, I feel like any like problems that arise within the relationship should be dealt with in the relationship. I feel like the only exception is if you're going to a significant elder, like somebody that's like your auntie or mum or something like that. I don't feel like you shouldn't be going to other people, our generation, for advice about relationships because nobody's experienced like that, number one. And two, their relationships are probably popping down and you're going to that single friend that's never been in a relationship, that don't know how to hold a man. And
literally, but that's you're not going to go to your friend that's kind of a slut for advice, are you? I disagree with everyone.
I think, in my opinion, there's two factors, I think there's a respect factor and the type of person you are. I feel like you can look at someone, you can both know someone. Someone has to show that they respect that you're in a relationship, innit?
Yeah.
Like, okay, if they, You know what I mean? Like they don't respect you. Like they, you know, they don't like if they know that. Like, all right, cool. They're a couple. I know my boundaries. Yeah. There's a line between things. Yeah. Yeah. I feel like that's it's acceptable to have a little best friend.
I feel like the moment you go out and ask for information, you're inviting people into your relationship to have an opinion, and nobody is gonna have no some sort of opinion about my relationship and what is going on. How like they start to come with suggestions.
They just gotta keep it to themselves.
Yeah, have your opinion.
But that's if you have to move.
That's not realistic.
Then you know like the type of people you surround yourself with. If you know you can't chat to your friends.
I personally say, I feel like to me, friends are more like family, innit? Because friends, you grow up as them as a person, you experience their bad sides and their good sides, regardless of a thing. And when you get into a relationship, I do love that person.
Yeah.
But always, you two can't have conflicts. Like, you two should respect, like you said, respect. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But you two can't have conflicts because I've grown up with you as a person.
Yeah.
And then you are falling in love with you. So I feel like the two sides, for me,
because me personally,
I have to go talk. I have to be the intermediate person to go sort things out. Yeah. But you two have to.
I feel like as soon as you go out there, you're allowing and you're asking for other people's opinions on your relationship. You're allowing information or doubt to come in the relationship and manifest itself. I like my thing to be inclusive. We sort things out. We argue as much as we need to argue. No, not even that. Like, no. But I'm not going to nobody our age. I'm sorry. I wouldn't come to none of you lots with my relationship problems. Like, I'll come to you lots to vent probably. But I'm not going to take
advice. But is that advice. Not the same? Because when you vent, I'm going to answer. I'm gonna
you'll give me, but I'm not necessarily going to utilize the information that you respond back to me with. But sometimes
but it doesn't matter. You don't have to use our advice.
Yeah, but I'm like,
sometimes you might have to hear from someone.
No, but you have to remember you can't chat to your mom.
You have to go to someone to talk to you. Because you might think, no, I'm not wrong, he's wrong.
Yeah, I'm not saying you're not going to nobody's
ask. You might need someone
to
tell you no, like a good friend or best friend to tell you no, you're the one that's actually wrong.
I'm going to somebody that is older, like 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. I'm not going to nobody our age.
But you have to remember, people who are older than us don't always understand.
Yeah, they'll probably laugh in your face about some little argument.
I think it's about perspective. It's about
perspective. If you was 24, 25 and you're in a relationship with a girl that's 24, 25.
I don't believe there should be a communication barrier in that relationship if they're 23, 24, 25.
No, but that's what we're saying. But you then two, remember, I think, look, they think you're wrong, you think they're wrong. So if you two just sit down and talk about it, of course, like the girls, you might like speak to her best friend and be like, you know, this happened, blah, blah, blah. I just want to know, like, how do, like, what
But then that's when best friends feel like they can come and have their chat in a relationship.
Yeah, but that's when you set boundaries with your best friend. Yeah, and it's about perspective. It's like, if
sometimes best friends cross that boundary though, can't lie. I feel like, cool, you're going to your best friend or so say, or anybody that you speak to, you and that person can fall out, and then that person, you can't, like, you can be like, it might be the title of friendship or whatever, but that friend can go back and bait out all of your business and stuff like that.
But that's what you say to them.
Yeah, but you don't
know
that up until that moment happens though.
That's peak, but at the same time, you also have to, even though that's your best friend.
Yeah, that is your, exactly.
No, but that's my issue with, my issue with that statement is that, because that, okay, let's say throw the relationship aside, even that's what we're talking about. That could have been about anything I told them. Yeah, so what? So it's like when you say those type of things, it's like you're meant to have that fear about every single friend you
have. I get that, but relationship.
But the type of person I am, for you to even be my best friend, you are like me. So you would never do that.
No, exactly. But you don't know because people change all the time.
It's that's true.
But that's when you. The fact that everybody is aware that that could always be a possibility. Someone could just turn around and stab you in your back. You have to manage. You have to watch what you say to someone. If you know you say to someone, you say something to someone one time, and you, because me personally, if I don't talk to people about like anything personal because I know if you was to go and run your mouth, I wouldn't be happy. I tell people everything, anything I speak to any of my friends, anyone about is things that if it was to come back to me, I would know I can back myself and I wouldn't feel embarrassed. Do you get it?
Yeah.
So even the closest of friends that I have, I don't tell them anything where if they decided to badmouth me, they decided to go off on one and start chatting my business, it's not business that I would be out here like,
just depends on how you feel about the person. You could be around someone for years and be a bit shaky about them. But meet this person yesterday.
Yeah.
I would say find out what the issue is, address the issue. If it can be resolved, you know, happy days. If it can't, for whatever reason, they just have to both respect you and learn to just be yeah. civil, like around you and all that type
and establish boundaries in terms of communication and stuff and all of that. I'm chatting to a GM, but I don't want to tell him what area I live in, because he will stop talking to me. What do I do? Find a regular nigga. Cut it.
Simple. Hey, guys, it's the last dilemma.
Last one.
So, I was getting jumped. My day one just watched me, just stood still watching me, innit? And he didn't do anything. 2 weeks later, he tried to come back to me, try to make peace, try to be like, I thought it was so cool. What would you do?
I'm beating up the friend. If I'm getting jumped, obviously I'm getting beaten up badly. And if you are standing up there, watch me get beaten, you even try to do nothing. Obviously, jump must mean, I don't know, probably more than one person when you're getting jumped or whatever.
Or
so
even
more.
One person.
Jumped is like four people.
Yeah. If you're getting jumped, or even if you got jumped by one person, I feel like, if you're getting, like, if for some reason you haven't, like, bounced back from getting, like, a couple hits in your face, and you're all getting fucked up now, I'm jumping in, like, but if you didn't jump in and you're trying to make peace to me,
like, I'm looking at it as, like, for you to even be there in a moment of fact, you're probably one of my close day ones, innit? So if you can sit there and watch me, stand up there or sit there or whatever you're doing,
maybe
watch
you set me up.
Well, I think it depends on the gender, to be honest. And like, I feel like if you're a girl and the girl's getting jumped by bare girls, and the girl, I feel like she should try and, like, get in between or something. Mm. I thought, girl, for boys, us boys got like
pride.
Like, you got pride too.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying, but it's like a manly thing. You're a boy, you're expected to do stuff. You got a carrier.
If my girl was there, I just wanted to watch me. I don't want to get involved. So let me just watch me get beat up. It's fine.
Watch me get beat up.
It's fine. You're not coming get involved. Don't
chat. If it's a boy though,
girl best friend. Yeah. Just watch me.
If it's my boy though, he's not your friend. Like, you have to punch him up. Like,
for you to be there, you must have been my guy or something. And you're just gonna come up.
Can I ask a question? Because you are saying, oh yeah, you would fight them. Blah, 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 blah,
no, but
whatever.
The thing is,
but I'm saying, like, the person showed up 2 weeks later.
2 weeks later.
At the door, and if that's, I feel like, if we're being real, obviously I don't know like how boys thinking it, but I feel like if that's your friend, I know they violated you, but you wouldn't do what your friend did to you. Do you know what I mean? So I feel like, would you really fight them if they turn up to your doorstep? Like,
moving up, but
two weeks later, it's not like it's just after the fight, but you're still mad.
They have to get a tongue for it because they didn't experience a tongue for it then. Get it? Like, if they got involved then, they would have got a couple of tongues.
You left it for 2 weeks. You should have been apologizing. But not even that. No, I wouldn't even want no apology. Because straight out there, you just watch me. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You can't be rocking with a friend after that.
You're not really my friend like that. Like, no, I mean, I'll be civil with you.
What if those boys backed out a knife on me or something?
If you came to my door, I mean, I'm dropping a brick out the window. That's what it is, fam. Because I'm not even gonna fight you. Or, like, I'm not even gonna give you the satisfaction of my fist. I'm dropping something out the window to lick you in the head because you could have, like, no, you can't watch me.
One thing I want to say, get beat up. One thing I want to say, is there's two sides to this. And the first side is like what everyone else is saying, that's a vile, because it's not like 1v1 and you are losing. Even and it's like, okay, cool. It's like, you were getting beat up by multiple people.
Yeah.
They could have cracked you in a way where, like, it was devastating.
You weren't bouncing
like,
back from
you
that
couldn't, one. Like, you couldn't recover. Like, they could have beat you up to the point where it's like, okay, cool, I might as well be dead. Like, it could have been very severe because you don't know how extreme it, like, how extreme.
I don't
how
do
bad
one
they were beating
one
the person up. Wait. And my second, like, the other side is that at the same time, if your friend is one of these people that are constantly getting into beef, and it's like, it's getting exhausting now, and you low-key think, you know what, maybe you deserved a bit of a beating, like, maybe, not on like a bad mind thing, but like, a wake-up call, that not every time you get into something, your friend should just be there.
I feel like, if your friend inflicted that situation upon themselves, I feel like you as a friend should jump in that situation, fight it, and then after that, cut the friendship off because that allows you to act out of character, kind of thing. I don't think you should let that person get beat up and then not do anything about it. Set the example, beat that person up and then cut the friendship off.
I agree. I feel like if you're like a troublemaker and you're constantly getting yourself in issues, I feel like that friend does not have any obligation to help you because you're always putting yourself in problems and they could end up more injured than you. Although me as a friend, I would jump in and then just be like, "Right, like, what's wrong with you?" But if it's a continuous thing, like, I'm not gonna get myself hurt because, you know, it's not only boys that's carrying around knives and all this type of stuff, there's girls too. So I'm not going to get myself in a situation where I can come out worse off than you for your situation.
Because it's like you're constantly forcing me to act out of character, and then if you're doing that to me, I put you in a situation. But then
I don't owe you nothing at that point if you're causing
it. Because you're not having consideration for me as a friend if you keep putting yourself in a situation I'm constantly having to back you. I'm fighting that last fight and it's done kind of thing.
But even if I'm having a one-on-one, that, because obviously I'd love to have one-on-ones with people, but I just expect as a naturally my friend. No. What I'm saying is, If I was ever having a one-on-one, because if my friends are there, I don't mind having one-on-ones or anything. But my friends are there, they're my friends. They can't see me fight. I expect them to just involve themselves. They're, like, if I see my friend having a fight with someone, I feel like naturally I'm just involved in that fight. Because if it's my cousin or something fighting, that's my people. My friend, that's my people. I'm backing them no matter what, one-on-one or nothing. And I'm not, when I said that I like to fight, to fight in packs. That's not me saying, oh yeah, let me get all these people so you can beat up one person. That's me saying, if I'm just getting myself into a situation where I'm having a fight with someone and my peoples are there, I'm just expecting them to back me. So in basically in a not cowardly way, I just expect my friends to back me all the time and I'll back them.
So guys, that brings us to the end of our video. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe.
I hope we solved your issues and your dilemmas.
Just tell us how we did in the description below.
Don't forget to follow all of our socials.
And make sure you look, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I am Nelly. Subscribe.
If you're looking for anyone's socials, anything, will be down below or on the screen.
Make sure you add it still.
And make sure you guys comment how you lots would have dealt with the situation. This is a real life situation that you lots have literally sent in for us to answer. So I hope you guys take it on board and literally do better for me, because not gonna lie, some of these dilemmas are kind of trashy still. So
don't forget to hit the notification bell.
See you in the next video, guys, and thank you for watching.
Trying to reach is currently unavailable. Please leave a message after the beep.